Welcome. I'm Lauren, and I manage the day-to-day operations of the Burst team at Amplify. I'm excited to tell you about Burst Practice App. We'll start with an overview of the app, why you should use it, and how to use it. We'll also review how to download the app, how to get kids to log in quickly, and how to keep kids invested and excited. I'll wrap up with a discussion about monitoring usage and getting kids started at home. Burst Practice App is a set of games that gives your kids practice with early literacy skills. On the left, we see a rhyming game where kids choose the picture that rhymes with the word they hear. On the right, we see a game where kids hear a sound and tap on the letter that makes that sound. Oh, and see the Boost label in the middle picture? We gave Burst Practice App the name Boost, so you'll hear me using that name going forward. Boost works on iPads, iPhones, and iPods. And each game is linked to an early reading skill taught in Burst. The skills include phonological awareness, letter sound knowledge, sounding out and blending, regular word knowledge, irregular word knowledge, letter combination knowledge, and advanced phonics. Boost teaches decoding, so we recommend having all your kids that are working on decoding use it. In most schools, this means giving Boost to all of their kindergarten, first grade, and below grade level second graders. Let's take a look at one of the phonological awareness games called Zoom Boom. In this game, kids choose the picture that rhymes with the word they hear.
Which one rhymes with gate, wait, pay, sign?
Practice is key to becoming an expert. Take Mozart, for example. Many believed he was born with his musical talents. The assumption was that his ability to name notes was a gift that others couldn't develop over time. We now know, of course, that anyone can be trained in perfect pitch, especially if they learn between the ages of 3 and 5. Mozart achieved so much in his life because he spent many hours perfecting his craft. Michael Jordan's story is similar. After not making varsity as a sophomore in high school, he turned his rejection into motivation for improving his game. He practiced and worked out every day until he had the skills to join the varsity team the following year. And as we all know, he's now considered to be the greatest basketball player of all time. For many kids, like you know, practice is key to becoming proficient readers. They need daily practice identifying the sounds and words that will help them lock those new skills into their muscle memory. And that's where Boost comes in. Boost increases practice opportunities, which increases your kids' fluency with early literacy skills. It helps kids continue practicing what you and others are teaching in core and intervention. Your kids can play Boost at school during a rotation station, lunch, or before or after school. They should also play Boost at home, at night, and on weekends. We recommend 10 minutes per day for kindergartners and 15 minutes per day for first and second graders. Some kids may not be ready for practice on Boost every day, though. If your kids aren't ready, don't force them to play. You will see what we call clicks without real thinking, which won't help your kids. This should be avoided at all costs. You're now ready to download Boost, so let's get to it. On an iPad, iPhone, or iPod, you will tap on the App Store icon, search for Amplify Boost, tap on Get, then Install, and lastly, you'll be prompted for your Apple ID. Type it in and wait for the app to download. If your device doesn't have iOS 9 or higher, you will also be prompted to update your operating system. Next, you'll want to get your students' logins. Log into MClass Home. Click on Burst Reading, then click on View Dashboard. This is the Boost dashboard, and there's a lot more to discuss, but we'll save that for the end of this video so we can stay focused on getting your kids' logins. Choose your class or group, then click on Print QR Codes, then click on Print This Page to get your students' logins. Your kids will log into Boost with their codes like this. A note about logging out. Boost will automatically log your kids out after 30 minutes. If you use Boost at a station, ask your kids to log out when they're done so the next group of kids doesn't play using the previous student's logins. If a student plays Boost while logs in as another student, the app won't have accurate data about what each student can do. It's helpful to keep your kids' QR codes in the same place, so getting started every day takes only a couple minutes. Some educators keep their kids' QR codes next to pictures of each kid on a wall, like this. As your kids play Boost, recognize their progress with statements that promote a growth mindset. When kids unlock eggs, praise students' effort with specific feedback, such as, "I can tell you've been working hard on letter sounds." Kids who haven't yet unlocked eggs should also receive feedback that reinforce effort and risk-taking. For example, you could help your student and then say, "I like how you keep trying."
Remember I said I'd come back to the dashboard? We're back. If you're an intervention coordinator, school leader, or teacher, you will want to monitor boost usage to make sure your kids are getting enough practice. First, click on a class or group and set the time frame you're interested in. From this report, you can see the date each student was last active, the progress they're making in games, and how much time they've spent on the app during the selected time frame. You can also unlock games like you see here, but the app will adapt to your students' needs, so we don't expect you'll do this frequently. Intervention coordinators, school leaders, and teachers will also want to look at an individual student's stats. You'll do that by clicking on a student's name, and then you can see for each game, the last date played, average score, max score, average play time, and total number of plays.
Kids whose parents have an iPad, iPhone, or iPod can play Boost at home. Print QR codes for each kid's parents and attach them to our flyer, which you can find directly below this video on Burspace. Let parents know that kids should never be forced to play. They should only have kids play the games when they are excited to play. If you have questions, reach out to Amplify's educational support team on live chat, email, or phone anytime, Monday through Friday between 8 a.m. and 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Thank you for listening.